Welcome. If you're new via here, be sure to click the subscribe button and also click the bell icon so that you'll be notified about videos uploaded from this channel. People, wagwan. Right now, I'm coming for going to a shocking update on the teacher that was shot and killed yesterday in St. Elizabeth. It is said that she was in an abusive relationship. Here's that story in details. Chanel Smith, the St. Elizabeth teacher who was murdered at her school gate yesterday, was a victim of domestic violence, her father said. Smith, 28, was shot and killed outside the Sandybank Infant School in St. Elizabeth by one of two men who opened fire at her as she was about to enter the schoolyard. Her father, Vernon Smith, said that the young woman has been going through hell since 2019. He claimed that she was threatened on several occasions by an ex-boyfriend who assaulted her on at least one occasion. I remember one night the family was at home and we hear tussling coming from upstairs and me hear my daughter say, "Lego my throat," the distraught father said yesterday. "When I go up there, I saw the guy and I said to him, 'What are you doing in my house?' He turned and asked me, 'Oh, me get in at this,' and I told him to get out my house or else." Smith said that after an heated exchange between him and the man, the partner left. The father said he and his daughter reported the matter to the Treasure Beach police station. He told our news team that his daughter suffered in silence before opening up to him about what was happening. He said that on one occasion, the ex-boyfriend went on a school compound where his daughter worked, grabbed her by the throat and attempted to choke her. "Them called me and I called the police, so the police went there and warned him," said Smith. Up to press time yesterday, the police had not disclosed a motive for the killing. In addition, there is no indication that yesterday's deadly attack is linked to the abusive relationship she endured. As investigations continue, the St. Elizabeth police have listed a Manchester man as a person of interest. The police said that he frequents Royal Flat and Christiana in Manchester. He is now in police custody. His name is Damien Robinson, otherwise called Starboy Miles. While the police have moved to solve the murder, which is the 21st in the parish since the start of the year, the grieving father is calling on the government to impose a stiffer penalty against criminals. "I can just imagine when she feel the first shot. She must been saying, 'Is this real? Is this real?' The problem I am having, Jamaica has no justice system to correct these problems," Smith said. "When you are caught with an illegal firearm, put 50 years on it, and when you commit murder, put away forever. No bother with no lawyer, and this and that. No income, just put them away," the father said. Yeah, pops, if we can't agree upon none else, we all can agree that our justice system sucks. And we know that for a fact. But you can't just put away these persons or these accused just like that. Remember, say innocent people get accused daily. So basically, you just put away people innocent some of the time too. But if you are proven guilty now, I totally agree that them get locked with forever. Them forgot the couple years well for the illegal weapon. Because as them get put away for the 6 months or the 2 year or the 3 year what them get for the illegal weapon, they are coming back to go up on the road with the next one. If them get put away for take with somebody 3 points and them come back within 10 years, 15 years, they are coming back with revenge. So me totally agree with this father. Put them way. Once them find guilty, then the need for come back for no, make them go and relax themselves around this. So, but the next part of this story what I really want to talk about is this ex-boyfriend. Oh, you want beer face, so? Oh, you left from which by you day and ganga harass the girl at workplace. She is working in a public space. Not only that, but she is working with children. And you mean for tell me, say, whatever happened, you could wait until she come from work before you address her. You have left for you ado and go workplace go do that. You know, like when your parents follow you come to school and the teacher tell your parents, say, you know, your child hasn't been behaving and them not them schoolwork, or your parents call you up at school and go on with themselves. Well, not all parents, but some of them. This man behave like say him a the girl father. You even have the audacity for being a the girl father's house. A wall up in her neck up this so. oh, your bare face, so, oh, you're so dry eye. Must see a lot of persons on the internet stating that the police, them don't really care when these things are happening. But if we should be honest, in most of these cases, the victims always go court, go tell the judge, say, dear Anna, I'm not going to go further with this case, just drop it. Or when the police come, or them go to the police station, go report the matter, them tell the police, say, officer, I just want you to warn them, and that is it. When you warn them or when you drop the case, if they are obsessed with you, they will come right back. So when them come back and them go at you again, it only go show in the public for who don't know the full story, say the police them not them work. And me not try cover it up for the police them, because we really have some police who really don't care when these things are happening. Them just go, take the statement, and them not really business will want happen after that until them have to go take up the person off of the ground and bag them up and carry them down at the morgue. But I am saying, in most of the cases, as I said earlier, drop the case them out of fear. Them afraid of what the accuser come back come do, or the accused threaten them. This man threatened this woman multiple times, as the father say. So why when she got the police station, him not going to trip her again? Uno just think about it. So it can be a case where she never want the police them for doing nothing. She just want the police them for warn him and make him stay away from her. But we can't say him yet. And we not going to say an him, because we know how the streets go. We know all their money is there, because you're not supposed to leave them when you feel it's not working out. If them not leave you, no left you not supposed to go on. That are how some of these men are thinking these days. So when I to jump to a conclusion and say he is not involved, but somebody who is a person of interest in this matter was taken into custody sometime today or late yesterday. We are now waiting on the police to run their investigation, find out what is what, and hopefully the father and the rest of family members get justice, because this is unfair, especially for the people that were left traumatized. You're going to have some baby who are afraid to go back to school. Not to mention the teachers and the parents, them. This just sat bad. She looks like a very nice girl. She is very beautiful. It's just sad her days was cut so short. Viewers and subscribers, a year time now. I would love to hear what are your thoughts and all these stories down below in the comment section. Remember, everybody's opinion is valid, so not afraid to leave your thoughts down there. We have made it to the end of our next video. Thank you guys for watching. Catch you guys next time. I'm out, and stay blessed and stay safe.